Hi, this is InfoPuppet, and I'm going to show you how to create digital snow, both falling from the sky and on the ground, in my next Photoshop Elements tutorial. Alright, we have Photoshop Elements 11 open up. This will work fine for PE 10 and PE 12. This is the image we're working on today. A beautiful sunny day. I love it. We're going to go to Enhance, Adjust Color, and Replace Color. Now you automatically get the color picker, so I'm going to go ahead and select the color blue. Now I have to click on this box at the bottom to tell Photoshop Elements what color I want to change blue to. I made a rhyme. All right, look at that. Look how cool. It's changing the color of the sky, but what I pick out, I'm going to select OK. And that looks pretty good. All right. Now we're going to select the rectangle marquee tool. I'm drawing a little rectangle in the glass. And I'm going to select and grow. And look at that. Photoshop Elements just grew my selection to the grass exactly on. But I need it a little bit bigger, so I'm going to grab the selection brush tool and I'm going to get the selection. We need it over the shrubs because we need some snow on our shrubs. What's a snowfall with no snow on the shrubs, I say? I'm changing the size of my brush by clicking on the bracket keys on the keyboard. I'm showing you on my screen in the lower right hand corner when I'm doing this. Now we're just making my brush size very small. I'm getting the tips of the roses here and I'm going up the pine tree. Gotta get some snow on the pine tree. That looks good. Okay, let's go to Enhance, Adjust Color, and Replace Color. Now I'm going to click on the green color in the grass. See, there it is there. And now I'm going to click on this box to tell Photoshop Elements what color to change it to. And I'm going to select the color at the top of the mailbox. Cool. It's kind of not white enough, so I'm going to come down here to lightness and slide this up a little bit to give me the perfect look of snow on grass. Okay. Looks good. I just hit Control D or Command D to get rid of the selection. Getting chilly. Alright, let's go up here and select the rectangle marquee tool. I'm drawing a little marquee on the bushes over there and now I'm going to select and grow. And look at that! Selected the bushes perfectly! Now we're going to Enhance, Adjust Color, and Replace Color. I just clicked on the color of the bushes, and now I'm clicking on this little box at the bottom to tell Photoshop Elements what color to change it to, and I selected the white on top of the mailbox. I'm kind of predictable. Okay, now we want to put some snow on the shingles, so I took my rectangle marquee tool and drew on there, and now we're going to select and grow, and blah! Too much! We can fix that by going to the brush tool, the brush selection tool, and we can hold down Alt or Option, and now the brush selection tool will let us subtract from our selection. Looks good. Much better. Okay. Now we're going to go ahead and go to Enhance, Adjust Color, and Replace Color. Now I'm clicking on the color of the roofing shingles. And now let's get the mailbox. So I tell Photoshop to change it to the color of the top of the mailbox. I just clicked on that and now the top of the mailbox and boom! Bah! What happened? No, this is all wrong. InfoPuppet stinks. Why do I listen to a stupid dummy? Well, let me show you. To fix this, all you have to do is turn down the saturation. Sometimes you have to make some adjustments with these things. It's gonna be okay, relax. Sheesh. Okay. That looks good. Good chili. Alright, now what I'm going to do is we're going to go up here and create a new layer by clicking on the Create a New Layer button. And we need to get black at the bottom, so we'll work with those buttons there. And now I'm going to click on Command and Delete, or Control and Delete. That'll make Photoshop Elements fill the layer with the background color. Now we're at Filter, Noise, and Add Noise. I love to add noise, I'm a noisy kind of dude. Alright, now I'm going to turn this up to about 100, okay? What we're doing now is creating the snow falling from the sky. Now we're going to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Gaussian Blur should be at 2. Now this is 2, not 0.2, but it should be at 2. Okay. Now what I just did was I clicked on Command L or Control L for PC to bring up this levels box and get the three triangles close together, and that's going to give you your best look. Okay, looks great. Alright, now what I'm doing is I'm going to Filter and Blur and Motion Blur. And here you can kind of direct the angle of the blur. I like it kind of at an angle so it looks like the snow is getting blown in the wind. That looks great, okay. Now I'm going to change this from normal to screen, and look at that! It looks awesome! Alright, what we're going to do right now is check out some before and after pictures. So here is before and after, and before and after. Thank you so much for watching! Do me a favor and click on subscribe or leave a comment. I'd love to hear from you from InfoPuppet!